Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of PVC training series. Now we have a family of more than 1,000 subscribers. I want to thanks all my subscribers for helping me throughout this journey. Please keep supporting me in this way and please share my videos with your friends so that we can educate our friends about the renewable energy and solar energy. If you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button for more tutorial of solar power plant. Now let's come to our today's topic. Today we will cover the 5 tabs of PVC software. When I started my PVC training series, so many people asked me about the near shading drawing in PVC because it's having some challenging stuff, and to draw the different kind of objects is much more tougher than any other user interface. As we already cover up to the detail losses tab, today we will cover that near shading and module layout, which is our main focus. Before wasting any time, let's get started. So as we already cover up to the detail losses tab, so today we will talk about silk consumption, storage, horizon, near shading, and also module layout. First of all, let's go to the silk consumption tab. For large industry or for any household, when you install a solar plant, if you define the silk consumption in PVCs, then PVCs will do the analysis and let you know that how much energy has been consumed for your purposes and how much energy has been exported to the grid. That means after consumption of your own load, of your household load or industry load, how much amount of energy has been exported to the grid. For that purpose, you can mention the consumption details or load details of your particular house or particular industry where you are planning to install the solar. First point, what you can see here, fixed constant consumption. In technical terminology or in power system study, there is a term called base load. For emergency purpose or for any kind of circumstances, which amount of energy consumption is remain constant, that is known as base load. And here you can see that there are different kind of units is available, kilowatt hour, megawatt hour, so as per your choice you can mention that. The next point is the monthly values. So in the monthly values tab here, so if you just select on monthly values, so you have to define your requirement, like you have to define the month wise consumption or power requirement details. So you have to mention that thing, as it's known as user's need. As you can see here, it's written here, user's need. And here also unit details also there. If your unit is kilowatt hour per day or megawatt hour per day, you can mention it. Now we talk about the daily profiles. As you can see here, the daily profile, in daily profile, so new user's need. So as per your requirement, you can mention your hourly values. So as in a power system study or in load flow studies, it's known as the time block. So as here, the hourly time block is mentioned, the 24 number of time blocks is there. Also, you can mention the unit, like what is the energy requirement. It can be kilowatt, it can be watt. Okay, so and it will automatically calculate the average requirement and daily requirement of the energy. Generally, when we are doing the PVC's design, so in that case, we don't have the consumption details and also we don't have that kind of load profiles with us. So that's why we are considering here no auto consumption, because when we are planning for the grid tie system, your consumption and the export energy will be automatically adjusted by the net meter. So there is no requirement for that. So you can click on OK. So this is the process of self consumption. Next is coming up the storage. Here the storage part is totally comes into the picture. If you are installing a plant and there is some kind of storage facilities available, like if is there any kind of battery system, then you can mention the storage details. Like you have to mention all the details of the storage pack, all the details of the battery, how much temperature has maintained there, what is the maximum charging, minimum discharging. These things you have to mention here. But we are not supposed to connect the on-grid inverter with any kind of battery or any kind of other storage system. But there is an option called DG synchronization. I will talk about it later. So that's why we are not considering anything in storage phase. So no storage. Now, a very important part. So as I already skipping these two parts, we are not putting any data. So now here we can put some data. When we talk about the shadow analysis in PVSYS, or when we talk about the shadings in PVSYS, there are two options. The first one is the horizon. As you can see here, it's mentioned as far shading. It's known as far shading. And another one is near shading. Now, what is the difference between these two? Far shading is basically, if you have an area where you are planning to install the plant, or you have done the drawing and you see that there is a building like nearby that particular roof, which can create shadow until the 8:30 or 8 a.m. in the morning. After the 8:30 or 8 a.m., the overall plant becomes shadow free. So in that case, you can install that plant. But up to that 8 a.m., you are losing some irradiance. So that's why your generation will be less. For that purpose, that horizon line comes up. So that's why, as the object is far from the particular plant or particular site, so that's why it's known as far shading. And in the near shading part, we have to draw all the objects inside the plant. That's why it's called near shading. So as the name suggests, this terminology comes. If we talk about this diagram, this is known as the sunpath diagram. Two, three things I need to just tell you guys before going to the horizon line. Here, that which azimuth is mentioned, this is the sun azimuth, not the azimuth what we consider during the orientation. And another one is the sun height. Sun height means the height of the sun. That means how the sun is moving. That means from the north-south plane, how the sun is moving. Now, to give you a better understanding of sunpath diagram, I'm just giving you guys an idea about how the curve is basically determined, because here the months are not mentioned. So after exporting the report, you will get a kind of curve. So as you can see, as per the number, the curves are showing here. So the maximum one, that means when the sun is for the long period of time in the sky, so that is the 22nd June, and the minimum one, which is the 22nd December. So as per this, you can just understand these curves means. So as you can see, there are two lines. This is represents the one, and this one represents the seven. So as you can see, during the 7 hour, that means during the 7 a.m. For summer time, that means for 22nd June, the sun height and sun azimuth, that means the sun height is almost nearby 20 degree and the sun azimuth is nearby 110 degree. In the same way, if we just go back to for the seven number, that means this one, this is the 7 number. So if you just go back to this line, so in this 7 hour, the sun height is minimum. So it means during the summer time, sun already rises and sun height has been increased. According to this, this curve generally maintained. So if you just see in this curve, that 22nd May to 23rd July, that means the second one, the second highest one, 20 April to 23rd August, this is the third one. And in this same way, this curve is generally maintaining. Here, basically, sunpath diagram is showing for the horizon line for the far shading. So if you just consider this horizon line, let's say we had an object outside of our particular site, and it can cover the site by shadow up to 8:30 a.m. in the morning. If you just consider the 21st up to 21st December. So in that case, you have to just mark that line in horizon, so that when PVSYS is doing the simulation, the software will neglect that irradiance data up to 8:30 a.m. So if you just go it in this way, you can just do it. So here, this is up to the 8:30 a.m. what I mark here. And if the shadow comes after evening, like after 4 p.m. or 4:30 or 5:30 p.m. So then you can mark in right side. So for the morning time, you have to mark it in left side. For the evening time, you have to mark it in right side. But if is any object consisting the shadow to overall plant, then you have to consider this one. Otherwise, you have to just leave it. So I am just leaving it as actual. So now let's just click on OK and let's go to the near shading part. Near shading is generally required for the shadow analysis in PVCs, like what we have done in SketchUp. SketchUp as a constructional software, so SketchUp don't have that analytics database to give you the particular simulation report according to the shadings. So that's why you have to define the near shading in the near shading drawing part. Drawing of near shading in PVCs is more difficult than any other normal 3D software. So that's why we have to just find it out a better way to do it. So the basic way is like if you have Scaleon, so you can export that PVCs H2P file and then you can import it to the software. Now what I am doing here, as we already done in our last video, that we already create that PVCs H2P file. If you have not watched that video, please go to the card. Now let's go to the file and go to the import, and here you will find that import Helios 3D file, because we have exported that file into .h2p file, so we have to go to the Helios 3D file. For your information, if you have any idea of Helioscope, or if you are drawing the shading analysis in Helioscope, so you can also import that Helioscope file here in PVCs. Okay, so import a Helios 3D file. So I already exported that file and I am just clicking in it and just import it. After import that file, you will find this kind of screen. Everything has been imported here, but here something you have to do. There is a option called system match. This will match the orientation and what are the thing you have considered in the SketchUp drawing or Scaleon drawing. So just click on it and you will get a option like update the variant orientation. So just click on it, it will become green. That means all the system definition has been matched. As it is exported from another software, like another Scaleon or SketchUp software, so that's why the drawing becomes this in this way. But if you just go to that render, so you will just get that everything is perfect. So what we have considered and what are the drawings we have considered, what are the modules we have considered, everything will be there. Okay, and let's just select this. You can just select it, and if you just move it in a like frontwards, so you can do it in this manner. So as you can see here, the all the thing has been imported here. Now just close the scene. So after closing the scene, you will get a kind of warning from the PVCs itself. Do you want to compute it now? So if you have to just go to the table, and it will compute all the objects and all the shadows, and then it will give you the shading factor for diffuse and shading factor for albedo. This is the general process to import the H2P file and did the drawing. Now I am just give you a brief idea about the near shading drawing, how to draw a kind of layout, but it's a long process, so I'm trying to sort it enough. So in this case, what I will do, I will take the reference from the SketchUp drawing, what I already done. I am just deleting this one, and then I'm just briefing about the user interface of the software. So if you want to create anything, like if you want to put any kind of objects, you have to go to the create button. Okay, so here in the create button, there are lots of things like elementary, building, ground object, polygon, PV table, PV sets. PV sets means for the ground, mount projects in a single plane, is we have to just place the modules. So in that case, you can use the PV table as sets. pivot table with frame. That means what we are considering in this case, pivot table with frame. So first create the shading objects. In this case, so we have to just input a cube. Now you have to give the width, length and height. As per the my SketchUp drawing, I am considering the inside diagram, like inside dimension, not the outside, because here in PVC's drawing I can't draw the parapet wall, so that's why I have to consider the inner side of the parapet. So I am considering the inner dimensions. If you just go here, this is 18, the width is 18, the length is 16. So 18 and 16, and the height of the building, so as we can't go for the parapet, so the height of the building is 12. So the building has been done, and now let's close it. And now you have to go for the another cube what we have here. Let's just check the dimension here, 2.5 meter by 3 meter. So again go to the create option, element free, the width is 3 meter, the length is 2.5 meter and the height is 2.5 meter. Okay, and just close it. So this is in this position. Now here in PVCs you can't move object in a normal manner just like SketchUp, so you have to go for the modify option. This modify option give you a three dimensional option, green, red, blue. Here we have to give the height as 12 meter, so 12 meter, 12.00. now what I am doing, I am just putting this one just attached to the wall, and here I'm just putting this one also attached to the wall. If you just go here, as you can see, if you just take this dimension, so it's 7.5 meter. So here in the x-axis it is, I have to just consider it as 7.5, so it's become in a middle position. And now how to place the modules, go to the create option and go to the PV table with frame. Okay, so just click on it, so you will get a frame like this. Now you have to consider the modules, like what is the number of modules you have. If you just consider the first set of modules here, it's 3 to 5, that means 5 P2. Here the orientation should be as selected as portrait, and the X modules, that means in a horizontal way, what is the number of modules is 5. In the vertical way, what is the number of modules, which is 2. Now you have to click on adjust to modules, that means your frame will be adjusted to as per the module dimensions. So if you just click on adjust to modules, you can see these blue lines cover up the outside to the modules, so that means the module has been set. Now just click on close, so you will get a module in this way. And now give it to the height 12.861. Now why 12.861? Because we have given some height to the module structure as 861 mm, so here we have to consider the 12.86. and now I am just taking it as, so we have just placed the module just at the edge. Okay, now if you just go to the SketchUp and if you just check it out, here you can see this is the 173 mm and this is 262 mm. So what I will do, I have to add 2.57 width as 173 mm, so it will become 0.173. it is 2.743, just let me mention it, 2.743. with the y-axis it's in front, so I have to make it as backwards, 15.96 minus as 262 mm, that means 0.262, so it will become 15.698. here we have the water tank, so how we will draw the water tank, so just go to the create option. So you have to use the, so in that case you have to use the hexagonal prism, so just click on it, so you will find a hexagonal prism like this. So now you can place it in this way, let's just place it. And if you want to copy anything, just click on it, Ctrl C and Ctrl V, it will be copied, but somewhere else. You have to place it according to your requirement. Okay, in this way you can draw the things. So this is the brief about near sitting drawing of rooftop layout, but this is generally possible as we already done the drawing in SketchUp. According to that dimensions, we have mentioned all those things here, and after completion of the drawing, you will get this kind of things. So this is basically for the rooftop layout. This is for the small system, and here we only use the PV tables with frame. So in the next video, I will tell you how to use the PV table as sets. That means for the ground mount project, what is the process to draw in near shading, and next just close it. This will also ask you, do you want to compute it now? So you can go to the table and also you can compute it, and it will give you the shading factor for diffuse and shading factor for albedo as well. And then close it and go to the module layout. So here these rectangle, green rectangle boxes are showing. These are basically the modules and set of modules what you have defined, which are here. The module layout basically means the string layout, but generally string layout done in AutoCAD only for large system. Here you can just mention the layout for the electrical losses only. So here the basic process is, first of all, check the module orientation. The first thing, here it is in portrait or landscape. As here we are considering the module in portrait orientation, so just select on portrait. Current subfield means what you have selected, and click on set modules. So the module will be automatically just come up. And another process is, go to the all subfields, select the module orientation and click on set all modules. Then all module will be positioned, and then click on auto attribution, distribute all. So this is the system based distribution. That means PV system will automatically divide the strings, and if you want to select the strings as per your choice, then you can do that. Just right click on every string, so it will, the string will be gone. So here I am just deleting the string 1. So as you can see, the string 1 has been just gone. And now if you want to position again the string 1 modules or any other string, let's say string 2 has been also deleted from here, then you can just replace the string 2 here. So just select the string 2 here, it becomes white. So select the string 2 here and left click on where you want to place the strings. So in this way you can do the strings as per your choice as well. Here I am choosing the auto attribution and distribute all. After the distribution, there is a option called shadings 3D. So you can click on calculate. So according to the sun position or sun movement, according to the shading, it will give you a beam loss and the electrical losses as well. So here the beam loss is 0.5%, as you can see. So this is the basic procedure. After completing that, you can click on use in simulation and click on OK. So that's it for today, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you have any question, please comment me. If you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. And if you think this video is helpful for you, please hit the like button. Thank you.